This is a Toyota Sienna. It has a 3.3-liter V6 engine, 3mz-fe. This car is here in the shop today because it overheated. So for diagnostic purposes, we ran the engine. We had it plugged into the scan tool so we could monitor the engine coolant temperature. And what we found is that the engine coolant temperature rose and rose and rose until the fans went on high speed. But the coolant temperature would not come down. So we checked real quick and we saw that this bottom radiator hose that you can see down there was staying cool or cold even though the coolant temperature was rising. So this meant there was no circulation through the radiator and through the engine. So what this led us to believe is that the thermostat was malfunctioning, and I'm trying to show you where the thermostat is located. It's down in that recess between the two cylinder banks. Fortunately, I have another engine sitting right here, exact same engine. And on this engine, it's easy to see where the thermostat housing is located and what you have to do to remove it. You have a tube coming into the housing that is bolted to the head, and then the housing itself is bolted to the block. Now, before anybody starts asking, no, you do not have to remove the engine in order to change the thermostat. I'm just showing you on this engine because it would be impossible to see on the engine that's in the car. So now we're going to proceed with this repair on this engine that's in the car. First, we're going to drain the coolant and disconnect the hoses, then remove the thermostat housing, then replace the thermostat. Here's a better view of what we have going on. The housing is back there, and we've taken off the three 10 millimeter nuts that hold it to the block. And we've gotten everything out of the way except for one more thing. This starter has to come out in order for this tube that is attached to the housing to move out of the way. So there you can see I have backed out the starter just enough, and that whole tube and thermostat housing can come out. On this 3.3-liter engine, 3MZ, the tube and housing is one piece. On the 1MZ, it's different. On the 1MZ, the tube and housing are separate pieces, and the tube inserts into the housing with an O-ring. And possibly that makes it easier to do on the 1MZ. And there you have a peek at the thermostat itself. It can come right out of there, and we're going to replace it with a new thermostat. But we're going to do some testing first. I keep this hot pot in the shop just for testing thermostats. Step one is boil the water. Step two, drop the thermostat in the boiling water. This is the old thermostat removed from the car. And we're waiting to see if this thermostat is going to open. Okay, the water, as you saw, was boiling, and this thermostat is sort of opening, but it's not opening very wide. Let's see if it continues to open. definitely should be opening. No, that is not opening. So this confirms that the thermostat was no good. Now we're going to test the new thermostat, because you cannot just assume that a new thermostat is good. This is the new thermostat. It's a OEM quality thermostat. Never buy a cheap thermostat. Spend the extra money. It's worth it. Let's see how long this one takes to open. And within just a few seconds, this one is visibly open. Now the thermostat, the new thermostat is in. The thermostat housing is back on. I've reconnected all the ground wires and electrical connectors that I removed. I've tightened down all the hose clamps. And before I call it good, I'm going to refill the system with water. And I'm going to pressure test for leaks. This is the coolant pressure tester. This is one of the most important tools in your arsenal when you work on coolant systems. It's a little pump that has fixtures that attach to different size radiators or radiator necks. You pump it up and see if the system holds pressure. Now what we're most interested in here is the thermostat housing and the hoses that we removed and then put back. We want to see if those are leaking. So I'm going to go ahead and pump this up and we'll see how we do. You'll notice that I have removed the windshield wiper tray because on this vehicle, it is not possible to attach the coolant pressure tester to the water neck without removing the water tray. I mean the windshield wiper tray. So there you can see I've pumped it up, and I'm not just going to look at this gauge and see if it stays. I'm going to go and look right at the thermostat housing and see if anything is coming up. I have checked under the housing. Nothing is coming out, and this needle is holding steady. So I think we're in the clear. I've put everything back together except for the windshield wiper tray and the windshield wipers. Now I'm going to start the car and let it run and monitor it to check that it is operating normally with the thermostat opening and all that. I'm about to start the car and I'm keeping my eye on the temperature with my scan tool. So right now it's ambient, 86 degrees. That engine has been running for a few minutes. The temperature is up to 172 degrees Fahrenheit. And very soon, we're very close to the OEM thermostat opening temperature. I should feel the bottom radiator hose turning hot as the thermostat opens. We are at nearly 180 degrees, and the bottom hose has just started to turn warm. So it's opening at 181 degrees, and the bottom hose is pretty hot. Seems like it's pretty much open now. So it opened at 180 degrees. This must be the temperature of this thermostat. You would think they put the opening temperature on the box, but no such luck. I think we have completed a successful repair. I hope that you've enjoyed this video and that you find it useful. Thank you for watching.